Is this another game?
Yep, just like the Minotaur maze you played earlier. This one's called the Dragon's Lair. It's the opposite of the Minotaur maze. You don't need figurines to play. The goal of the game is to bring the dragon back to his lair, but it's not as easy as it sounds. Once it reaches its cavern safely, it will give you one of its treasures. That's where I got one of the ingredients I used for my first potion.
Well, this game doesn't seem to be working for now.
Darn, they probably locked it.
Who?
Teachers. This is to help students who tend to forget their studies, like me, to focus on their schoolwork.
Dragonus Inferinus.
Thank you.
I want some dirty old roots. That's not the type of prize I was expecting at all.
These are Alunda roots.
So?
I never really listened in herbalism class, but we learned last week that these are often used in potion making.
Really? Then let's see if we can use them to brew a potion that will turn you back into a human. Don't worry, Zach. We'll find a way to change you back to human.
No, that's not what's bothering me.
What is it, then?
These quarters have always been so alive. But now it's all so quiet. Too quiet. It's totally deserted. What could make them all vanish overnight? I never had any friends in this school, but I'm extremely worried about what happened to the students and teachers.
Me too, Zach. I'm worried. This place looks like some sort of classroom.
Yep, we're in the herbalism classroom. Students learn how plants can be used in a multitude of magical experimentations here.
Zach, do you understand what this is?
Not really, no.
Master Nightingale said the teachers are hiding the items in their classrooms. This rune must be connected to the items in some kind of way.
Oh, that would explain why the teachers don't want anyone to touch those runes. You're a genius!
Another of these strange runes. Am I wrong, or are we in some kind of workshop?
It is. This is the forge. Here we learn how to craft magic items. We also learn about the different effects of the materials we use in crafting items. All of the forges are burning during class, and it gets really hot in here.
What are these up there?
No one knows. We asked the teacher about it, but he always dodged the question, saying we wouldn't need to know about those for years. I heard some students say they were designed to craft extremely powerful magic items, but I doubt that rumor is true. Too bad there's no way for us to reach them and take a look.
Another of these strange rooms. These small islands float.
Almost everything in the upper section of the academy was built using magic.
What is this place?
This place is called the Oracle. Legend says there are remnants of a dragon on the last island. The way to get to it is hard, but when you do, it's possible that something mystic will occur.
Like what? Can you give me more details?
It's a bit foggy in my memory. If I remember correctly, the remnants of the dragon, which is called the Oracle, might contact you if you seek his help.
Is there any truth in this myth?
I never came here because of my fear of heights, so I have no clue. But some students claim they spoke with the Oracle.
Who knows? Maybe it could help us understand what's going on here. If someone needs help in this Vale, it's us.
I believe these weird giant stones are related to the secret way that leads to the Oracle.
Dragonus Inferinus.
Hey, Lydia, have you ever heard the story of the chimera you faced in your first trial?
No, I never heard it. Isn't this chimera just a statue?
Oh no, it's much more than that. It was once a creature of flesh and blood.
No way.
I swear it's the truth. Since the beginning of time, the chimera was one of the most feared creatures of the entire known world. And when Nightingale and Winter Owl came into the Vale to build the school, they had to deal with one that was living in a nearby cave. Fortunately, they managed to capture it and confine it in this stone prison using the mighty power of Orlos, the Earth Magic Rune. As a scary reminder of humanity's own fragility, Nightingale and Winter Owl used it to test the candidates coming to study in their academy.
Wow, that's an awesome story.
Thank you.
gosh!
That is by far the most amazing thing I've ever seen in this school. The legend about the dragon's remains was true!
Do you think the part of the legend about the remains helping students in need is true as well?
I don't know, but I hope the Oracle can help me turn into a dragon.
Whoa!
Whoa! What happened?
Look! After you wished to turn into a dragon, this big piece of moss appeared in my hand.
Maybe this is what I needed to complete the dragon potion recipe. What do you think? Lydia?
I wish to be reunited with Celeste.
Oh, hang on, Lydia. I'll do my best to make your wish come true.